Normally, I don't like New Year's Eve. I don't want to get all dressed up just to look at a clock, but I loved New Year's Eve 2009. I spent it at a dive bar in Chicago with two of my best friends, Dave and Eric. We drank craft beer. There was a great jukebox, and I will never forget, right before midnight, the song 1999 by Prince came on. But instead of singing, "Tonight we're gonna party like it's 1999," we sang, "Tonight we're gonna party like it's 2009, 'cause we're clever." And I cheers Derek and Dave, and I rang in that new year, and in that moment there was just this connection of true friendship, and I cherished it. Because as we got older, things changed. We talked a little less. Eric got married. He bought a designer golden doodle. It's a cross between a golden retriever and a poodle, because they can do that now. Dave moved to Ethiopia and started a very prosperous chicken farm, because that's the thing that people do. And I worked up the courage to finally try kombucha. So it was really just big life events across the board for the three of us. But we were growing up. We were growing apart. And the connection that had been so palpable, New Year's Eve 2009, it was fading. And I just wanted to go back to that moment. And then in 2016, Dave invited Eric and me to Ethiopia for Ethiopian New Year's. And that's different than New Year's here. Ethiopian New Year's takes place in the fall. It marks the end of the rainy season. And because there's no religious affiliation to the holiday, both Muslims and Christians come out to celebrate. So it's like the biggest party of the year. And Eric was really interested in going, but I was on the fence. I am admittedly a bit risk averse. Kombucha. But then Dave said something absolutely fascinating. So here's where you really pay attention, because I was floored. Ethiopians believe that Jesus was born 7 years later. And because of this, their calendar is 7 years behind the rest of the planets. So, for example, when it was 2007 here, Ethiopians were ushering in the new millennium. Okay, you can look this up. But I did the math in my head, right? This was 2016, so 2015, 2014, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. I could relive New Year's Eve 2009 with Eric and Dave. And that did it. I set that anxiety aside. I took a big chunk of my savings and I bought a plane ticket. And in order to just maintain these friendships, I needed things to be exactly how they were before. Okay? So same kind of bar, same kind of music, same kind of beer. And then to top things off, I went on eBay and I bought three pairs of those 2009 glasses with the zeros for eyes. A few months later, Eric and I got on a plane bound for Addis Ababa, Ethiopia. And 9,000 miles later, when we finally touched down, the captain came over the PA and he said, "Happy 2009, everyone." And this jolt ran through my body. I was like Marty McFly getting out of the DeLorean, like it worked. And so we met up with Dave, we put on our glasses, we gave him his pair, we took to the streets, New Year's Eve, the city was alive. These men on stilts marched by, and these herds of goats ran past us, and these vendors tried to sell us sticks of unwrapped gum. But I ignored all of this. I just got to the task at hand. I said, "Dave, where's the nearest dive bar?" And Dave laughed, because Ethiopia doesn't have dive bars. Strike one. But we got invited to a party at a club. And when we walked in, the DJ was playing this fusion between like rhythmic drumming and techno. And it's interesting, because you'd think that that mashup wouldn't work at all, and you would be absolutely right. It is terrible. So strike two. And I guess it kind of goes without saying, but there's not much of a craft beer scene going on in Ethiopia. Just this one beer that tastes like hot fermented corn. So strike three. And it was all different, okay? It was a different kind of bar, different kind of beer, different kind of music. It was all different, and I excused myself. And I was standing outside the club, still able to hear what was going on, but I was just so upset that this wasn't what I had wanted, and it wasn't what I had designed. so upset that I had wasted so much time and energy and money, and when I was at my lowest, the first and only song in English of the night came on. 1999, by Prince. Because if there's a universal constant out there, I think we can all agree, it's Prince. And one line stood out that never had before when he sings, "And life's just a party, and parties weren't meant to last." And it just kind of hit me, right? That in trying to recreate the past, I wasn't appreciating the present at all. And I was in Ethiopia, like with two of my best friends at the biggest party of the year. And this party wasn't meant to last. And so I snapped out of it. I marched right back inside. And as we sang, "Tonight we're going to party like it's 2009, because we're clever," I cheersed Eric and Dave, and I rang in that new year again. And that evening, as we danced with locals and drank the corned beer and ate the unwrapped gum, which was probably a mistake, it became readily apparent that these friendships that I thought had faded hadn't gone anywhere. I'd just been looking for them in the wrong place, in the wrong time. And the thing is, that connection with those two guys is still there. And I now know that if I ever want to feel that connection, that I don't have to do anything grandiose. I don't have to travel across the world. I don't have to travel back in time. With those two guys, both of whom I spoke with this morning, all I have to do is just pick up the phone. Happy New Year.